الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brothers, dear sisters, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of you, inshallah, all of your good deeds. Ameen ya Rahman Rahimeen. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, tonight, I've been before 2-3 weeks working in this subject, and I recorded it in almost 20 episodes in Arabic. But I said I have to say it in English too. Inshallah, in this 1 hour, we'll try to summarize this subject, which is very important because it is related to our creed and faith, and this it is actually part of our faith. Otherwise, if we're going to think in a different way, we'll do something against our creed and our iman and our deen. We'll talk about the keys of provision or livelihood. And we'll in details talk about that, inshallah, and how that related to our creed and aqeed. Because sometimes, because of the lack of our iman and faith, sometimes we think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just He did create you, or He created us, and He threw us in the middle of nowhere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving rizq even to those who are sitting partners with Him or beside Him. Rizq. Provision. Al-rizq murtabit, there is a connection, a relationship between the provision and the iman and the creed and the faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to worship Him with tawheed al-uluhiyya, the oneness of Allah. Tawheed al-rububiyya, Allah is the only one, we worship Him, the creator. And tawheed al-rububiyya also, it is we have to believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord. He is the one, if you became sick, He is the one who will cure your illness. If you are in need, He is the one who will satisfy you, who will give you. If you need help, He is the one who will help you. If you are whatever you need, He is the one who is taking care of you, like your father. Allah is not like your father. The father in the house, we call Him Rabbul Usra. Allah, the Rabb of all alameen. The Lord of all mankind, the one is taking care of you. And you have to believe also in Asma Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributes and good names. And one of the good names of Allah, Al-Razzaq, right? The one who's providing and giving you risk. And you have to believe also that's related to the risk. Huh? We have to believe also in the qada and the qadr, the destiny, good or bad. Today I don't have money, tomorrow I have money. This is my destiny. We have to believe in that. إفراد الله بالخلق والملك والتدبر والرزق. The only one who gave رزق, Allah. That's why His name, الرزاق. The only one He did, He created us, Allah, the خالق and the creator, سبحانه وتعالى. He's the one which is taking care of us. He's a sustainer, عز وجل. And those who are sitting partners beside Allah, سبحانه وتعالى, they have no power to harm you. They have no power to benefit you. They have no power to give you rizq. They have no power to cause you to die or to death. And they have no power to bring you to the life again after your death. They have no power. لا يملكون موتا ولا حياة ولا رزقا ولا نشورا. They have nothing. And I give example of the one who is worshipping others beside God, like exactly like what? Like if you have a slave, and that slave, no slavery now, imagine that you have somebody, you're a slave, like before. And that slave is working day and night, and he's giving the money or that thing which is, he's giving to somebody else, not you. Well, you are his master. This is the example of those who are worshipping others beside Allah. Allah, the one who created me, I'm his slave. How I give my ibadah to somebody else? How I worship somebody else beside him? Well, he is the one who did create me. That's why we have to worship Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala, without sitting in a partner with him. Look, infirad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil-rizq. Allah, the only one, we call him and we name him Razzaq, the provider, the one is giving you. Razzaq or Razzaq, you can say that. They say Abdul Razzaq, right? عبد الرازق, right? The slave of الرزاق, the one who's given رزق. We have to understand this meaning. سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام, Prophet إبراهيم, he understood that. Understood what? When he found his people worshipping idols, look what the Quran said. Quran declared that, and سيدنا إبراهيم, he told his people, إن الذين تدعون من دون الله لا يملكون لكم رزقا, لا يملكون لكم رزقا, فابتغوا عند الله الرزق واعبدوه واشكروا له إليه ترجعون. خلاص, that's it. It's a big title now. Prophet Ibrahim, when he saw his people worshipping the statues, he said, indeed, these statues which is you are worshipping beside Allah, they cannot give you rizq. They cannot provide anything to you. If you ask them, they cannot help you. They cannot feed you. They cannot give you water to drink. And he said, فَبْتَغُوا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الرِّزْقِ. If you seek provision, livelihood, seek it from Allah. Allah, the one who can provide you with that. Not just that. وَاعْبُدُوهُ. Huh? توحيد الألوهية. The oneness of Allah. وَاعْبُدُوهُ. Worship Allah alone. Worship Him alone. وَاعْبُدُوهُ. And be grateful to Him because He is a provider. He is the one He is giving you. All of us, إليه ترجعون. You will be back to Him. This is what سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام said. And he said in Surah الشعراء, in the end of the Surah, see عقيدة, it's a creed. قال فإنهم عدو لي إلا رب العالمين. Your statues, all of them enemy, an enemy, enemy to me, except رب العالمين, except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The one is what? Huh? الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. The one who created me and the one who is guiding me. الذي خلقني فهو يهدين. Your statue is my enemy. Except Allah, the one who created me, the one who guided me and is guiding me and the one who والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين and the one who is feeding me and providing water for me to drink. الذي هو يطعمني ويسقين. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah said, I created jinn and human, mankind, to worship me. This is the purpose of our creation, to worship Allah. That's why He said in the hadith صلى الله عليه وسلم, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَنزَلَ الْمَالَ. ليش؟ لإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. وي الله عز وجل give us money, wealth, for what? To establish الصلاة and to give زكاة. This is the purpose of money. To establish the عبادة الله in this earth, to worship الله عز وجل. وإحنا we have to understand that. الله سبحانه وتعالى create jinn and the ins to worship him. He said, ما أريد منهم من رزق. I don't need any one of them to feed me. I'm the one who is feeding them. وما أريد أن يطعمون. Why? Because indeed, Allah, He is a Razzaq, He is a provider. ذو القوة المتين, and He is strong. He is very strong, powerful. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the ayat. Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Surah Tabarak said, أَمَّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي يَرْزُقُكُمْ إِنْ أَمْسَكَ رِزْقَ. Any one beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can force Allah. He has power like Allah. He can force Allah to give you rizq if Allah wants to stop his rizq. He wants to stop providing you. Nobody can force Allah for that. Or anybody can sustain you if Allah stops sustaining you. Nobody. Because the only one who can give rizq, Allah. His name is Al-Razzaq subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave rizq between us different amount. Whatever you have is different from me. It's different from him, it's different from somebody else. Allah subhanahu wa jal faddala ba'duna ala ba'd for rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave superiority for some of us upon others. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran. Why? Why Allah make that? First of all, for the rich people to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rich person or the one who has wealth more, he must be grateful to Allah because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him more. طيب how he can be grateful to Allah سبحانه وتعالى just saying تشكر يا الله thank you Allah and that's it no it is not like that I see some people سبحان الله they have this مسبحة تسبيح they have millions of dollars I saw them in this country and even in Saudi Arabia before but mostly here they have money and he carrying this all the time in his hand الحمد لله شكر يا رب تشكر يا الله and he never gives zakah he has a lot of money this is doesn't work go give zakah don't say تشكر يا الله شكر باللسان وبالقلب وبالجنان how to make شكر الله سبحانه وتعالى with your tongue with your heart and also action with action he give you money give صدقة give your zakah سبحان الله It is not enough just to carry this and say تشكر شكرا الحمد لله. No. That's why Allah said in the Quran وأما بنعمة ربك فإيه؟ فحدث. How to say حدث with the نعمة of Allah, that bounty which is Allah gave it to you. How can you? So Allah said حدث. To be proud, guys, I'm the richest in the community. See, I'm wearing good عباية ما شاء الله. Look, this is the حدث. No. حدث means you have money, go give. صدقة, charity, give زكاة. This is the حدث. You have knowledge, go spread your knowledge. Be beneficial. Let somebody else get benefit from you. This is a way. And also the faqir, the poor, the rich person who must be grateful to Allah, if Allah give him. And the poor and the needy, he must react with what? Patience. Patience. Somehow Allah will help me in the future. And they have to react with a sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takaffala bi arzaq al khalaiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that in the Quran, I guaranteed your rizq. Your rizq is guaranteed. Your livelihood, your provision is guaranteed. Allah said that. لن تموت نفس حتى تستوفي أجلها ورزقها. No soul, no person will die until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him in full his rizq, provision, and his what? His life. Completely. Whatever written for him, he will get it. Death is running behind you. One day you will die. And your rizq, also provision, running behind you, seeking you. Even if you run away from your rizq, you're going to get it. I remember that story, that man, he was working in the balcony in the fifth floor. And somehow he was like that and he fell down. He fell down. And everybody was running to him. They think he died. And he said, Hey, it's still good. Oh, he did not die. Yeah, what's this? He said, yes, I'm good. Please give me some water. I want to drink. And they give him a cup of water. He drank it and he died. Because he still have this. he still have this. Drink it and he died. That's it. This is his rizq. See? So you have to take whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is written for you. You have to take it before you die. There is no way you cannot escape from your rizq. It's been written already. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote that, look, hadith said, إن الله كتب مقادير الخلق قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض 50,000 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything being written in the book of decree, لوح المحفوظ, before 50,000 years, before the creation of the heaven and the earth. Imagine that, 50,000 years before Allah created the heaven and the earth وكان عرشه على الماء and the throne of Allah was above the water Allah now wait if I ask you a question now which one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created first the pen or the arsh the throne ask answer again the question which one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did create first the pen or the throne The pen? Why? The throne? Why? The pen? Why? The pen or the throne? The throne. The verse said that. وكان عرشه على الماء. كان فعل الماضي. His arsh throne was above the water. Then, while his arsh was above the water, 50,000 years before the creation, the heaven of the earth. He created the pen after the arsh and he gave order to the pen, write everything until the day of judgment. Now I know you're going to say the pen because there is a Some scholars they mention that and they think no, عرش الله was before everything. The عرش was above the water. Then 50,000 years before the creation of the heaven and the earth, Allah created the pen and they give order to the pen, write everything to the day before to the day of judgment. Means your qadr, your maqadir, everything for you been written in the book before the 50,000 years before the creation of the heaven and the earth, and the arsh of Allah was above the water. See, we have to understand this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He guaranteed your rizq in this dunya, and He said, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this verse, Surah Hud, verse number 6. Each dabba, dabba, everything, the moving living of creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said its provision, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it down, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know about it. And He knows its permanent and temporary place. Like the temporary place, like what? When you was in the womb of your mother, right? It was temporary for 9 months. After that you get out, right? Okay, when you die, temporary or permanent, this is not the problem. Al-Muhim, Allah knows. Kullun fi kitab, everything been written in the book. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who guaranteed your rizq when you was in the womb of your mother without questioning Him or asking Him. Do you think He's gonna leave you alone now when you became, mashallah, a man? He's gonna throw you just in the middle of nowhere like this? Yalla, I create you, go like in the jungle? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's giving the kuffar. He will not give you to somebody worshipping Him and bowing and making wudu and making salah to Him. He's giving those who are sitting partner with Him. Okay. I read that story. Subhanallah. أحد التابعين said, I saw a bird carrying some worms flying above the very high tree. And above that tree, it was a blind snake. And the bird was feeding the snake. Because the snake is blind. See? Subhanallah. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who guided the bird to do that. There are too many stories like this. I have a story about Hatim al-Asam also. Hatim al-Asam, he was a good tabi'i, a scholar. One time he told his wife, I want to go for Hajj, or some scholar, they said he went for seeking knowledge. And his family, they complained. They said, Dad and his wife, where are you going to leave us? You know, we are very poor and we need somebody to take care of us. He said, I will leave you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will take care of you. One of his daughters, she was very good believer lady, or good mu'mina. She told her mom and her sisters, brothers, please let my dad go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of us. One day, two, three, 1 week, days left. And what happened is, subhanallah, their food done. There is no food anymore in the house. And everybody was looking at this girl like that. See, you are the one who insists my dad to go, and you help him to go, and you give him the idea. Look, we don't have any food now. What are we going to do? And she said, just depend on Allah. Allah is going to give you rizq. Our dad is a good man. Allah will not leave us alone like that. Somehow we're going to get rizq. Just this is trust. Depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, somebody was knocking the door. And they opened the door. They found very big man, good looking, riding his horse, and around him too many horses with riders also around that man. And that man, somebody asked for water. Give us some water for this man to drink. Do you know that man? Who was Abu Ja'far al-Mansur, the leader of the Muslim Ummah, the Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believing people, the believers, the top first man for the Muslim Ummah. He was passing by the house. Allah guided him. He said, I want to drink water from that house. He did not know even that belongs to who. And he drank the water. He said, that water is good. I like the taste of the water. Maybe he was thirsty. And he asked, who's that house belongs to who? They said, this belongs to Hatim al-Asam. Oh, the scholar, Hatim al-Asam? Yes. Who's taking care of his family? They said, nobody. Everybody, the assistants of the leader, and nobody. And you know, the old style people, they used to put like small bags of gold in their belt like this before. This is their wallet, you know? And Abu Ja'far al-Mansur, while he was riding his horse, it was gold and diamond. He used to throw like this in the house, like that. And they said, anybody loves al-Amir, the prince, he must do like what I'm doing. Even if somebody hates him, he will do it, but just to make him happy. Everybody was throwing like gold like this. Subhanallah. See, who did that? Who guided him to make that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Jawzi mentioned that story. فالله سبحانه وتعالى Almighty عز وجل He is the one again. He said وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْتُقُونَ In the heaven is your rizq. And whatever Allah promised you, it is there in the heaven. What do you mean, يعني? My rizq provision in the heaven? يعني I have to get a letter every day and they have to call. It's not like that, no. The meaning of the ayah, مقادير الرزق في السماء ولكن your provision, it is in the earth here. But the مقادير, the value, how Allah evaluated, how Allah sent it to you from there. Because everything under his control. Give this, give that, 5, 10, 15, 20 million, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this. In مقدار, the value of the rizq. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ سورة الذريات. فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْتِقُونَ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hijr, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا عِنْدَنَا خَزَائِنُهُ وَمَا نُنَزِّلُهُ إِلَّا بِقَدْرٍ مَعْلُومٍ From each and everything we have treasures. خَزَائِن, treasures. But when we send it with مِقْدَار, قَدَر, we evaluate it, and we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to his servants. We have to understand this meaning. قال مشيناها خطا كتبت علينا ومن كتبت عليه خطا مشاها whatever is written for you you gonna find you'll find it وارزاق لنا متفرقات this arzaq your rizq your provision you get some from there some from here some from this city from this country not from the same spot you have to work you have to run to get it وارزاق لنا متفرقات فَمَنْ لَمْ تَأْتِهِ مِنَّا أَتَاهَا If your risk is not coming to you, you have to run, get it. And some risk is coming to you while you did not do anything. مُكْتَسَبْ كده, just like that. Take it. You didn't have to work. Yeah, it is not the same. وَمَنْ كُتِبَتْ مَنِيَّتَهُ فِي أَرْضٍ أَوْ بِأَرْضٍ فَلَيْسَ يَمُوتُ فِي أَرْضٍ سِوَاهَا If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is written, it's written for you in the book, to die in certain place, certain spot, You will never die somewhere any different spot. One time, Prophet Sulaiman was sitting, King Solomon was sitting in Jerusalem. He used to be there in Jerusalem in Palestine. And his wazir was around him. And the angel of death came. He used to come in the form of a human being. And he used to sit with the prophets, angel of death. And his wazir was sitting beside Sulaiman like this. And the angel of death was staring at him like that. And he scared him, scared the wazir. And the wazir asked Sayyidina Sulaiman, please ask the wind, give order to the wind to carry me to send me to India. India is far away from Palestine, you know? And the wind was carrying him. And the Quran said that. وَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الْرِيحَ تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ رُخَاءً حَيْثُ أَصَابُ Allah made that subjugated the reeh, the wind, to carry him, Sayyidina Sulaiman. The carpet like this, and he used to ride it, and the wind was carrying him. Prophet Sulaiman, King Sulaiman. And because that wazir, he scared from the angel of death, and he did not know he was angel of death. So just I scared from that man, just take me away from him. And after that, he did. And the angel of death was talking with Sulaiman, and Sayyidina Sulaiman was talking to him, and the angel of death told him, I'm very surprised. This man, I get order to take his روح, his soul in India. Why he's still here? I'm very surprised. Angel of death was saying that. And the man, he escaped from him to India. And he said, I get order to take him, so his soul from in India. Subhanallah. So, وَمَنْ كُتِ أَيُوَا وَمَا تَدْرِ نَفْسٌ بَأَيَ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتٍ أيوة. فإحنا have to know this meaning. قال حاتم الأصم, بنيت أمري على التوكل على أربع أشياء. I trust Allah سبحانه وتعالى from four ways. I have four gates. All of them, they are going together in one point to let me trust Allah سبحانه وتعالى Almighty عز وجل. Number one, علمت أن رزقي لا يأكله غيري فلست أهتم له. I know with certainty my رزق provision, nobody else will take it except me. That's why I have confidence about that. Number two, علمت أن عملي لا يعمله غيري فأنا مشغول به. My good deeds, whatever I am preparing myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I know 100% nobody gonna work this for me. That's why I'm working for myself. You know, you cannot do anything like good deeds for me and you, this is me. Whatever I'm doing, I am the one who gonna find this and the judgment. وعلمت أن الموت يأتيني بغتة فأنا أبادره. He said, I know death is coming to me suddenly. For that's why I'm ready all the time for that death. I'm not waiting for death, just I'm ready for that. I'm ready for that. وعلمت أني في عين الله في كل حال فأنا أستحي منه. And I know 100% I am under the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is watching me, for I am very shy. I cannot do anything bad or haram while Allah is looking at me. Let's talk now about our subject, inshallah. We'll try to finish it because it's a big subject. The keys of provision. Too many people nowadays, especially those who have no job, or somebody is losing his money or business or is in failure somehow in certain things, especially about rizq. And when I talk about rizq, brothers and sisters, it is not just the money. People think rizq, provision, means money. No. Or livelihood means money. No. Rizq, too many things. I can count you. Money, one of them. Could be money, health, you're healthy, somebody sick. Huh? Guidance, Allah give you hidayah, guidance. Somebody is being misguided. Happiness in your heart, somebody's all the time sad. That rizq, too many things. You know the smile, when Allah give you that smile, He did not give it to somebody else, it's rizq. Very good kids, children, they are very obedient to you and they listen to you. This is rizq, provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not just only money. Knowledge, if you have knowledge, this is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not just only money. Hidayah, Islam, Iman, Salat al-Fajr, anything good, birr from Allah, it's rizq. It is not just the money. Hum 24 irat, 24 kirats. You have to take part of it. Not all of us will have it. Nobody in this dunya, I guarantee 100%, nobody in this dunya, he get the 24 karats, complete rizq. No. Allah give me knowledge, He give you money. Somebody is sick and he has money, somebody healthy and he has no money. You know, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He distributed somehow like this in His way out of His wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is wise and He knows what He's doing. The understanding itself, understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give some people understanding. Some people, they are very dumb. If you try to put all the knowledge in their mind, they cannot understand. It's a rizq. Allah gave it to you. It's a rizq. Even, do you know, when I talk to you right now, wallahi, it's a rizq to you. Whatever I'm saying, it's a rizq to you. I did not plan for it. Sometimes when I make khutbah, I did not prepare this. Just comes out from my mind like this. This is your rizq. This is your rizq. Allah wants somehow some word to come to the heart of somebody to change his life. You never know. You never know. Wallahi subhanallah. Rizq, too many things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us and He showed us in the Quran and the Sunnah the keys, these keys of rizq, how to get rizq easily. Somehow Allah will give it to you, but when it's different if you take it like this or you take it without benefit. But If Allah gave it to you full of blessings and in a nice way, easy way, it's different. And I'm talking tonight about this. Your risk somehow gonna come to you. But when you get it in easy way without working hard, and you get it full of barakah, blessings, this is what I need. I don't care about the quantity. I care about the quality. The quality of my salah, prayer. The quality of my worship. The quality of my good deeds. I don't care about the quantity. Some people, they pray 20 rak'ah every night, but alhamdulillah. Somebody, they finish the Quran. Alhamdulillah. What did you understand? Nothing. Jazakallah khair. This is not right. This is not right. You have to read, wallahi, if you read 5 verses every day, 1 verse, and you look for its tafsir, and you read it in the proper way, it's more than enough. You understand something today. You get some knowledge today. That's it. Huwa dal Islam. Try to understand and apply. Little by little, little by little, little by little. This is the way. I don't know, I want to make it long. Just let me go to the subject, inshallah. These keys of rizq, inshallah, like a tools in your hand. You can use it. And I said that example before. One cannot work with somebody, one can work with somebody else. See, for instance, Qasim Bai, he has the key of the masjid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 doors here in front of me. 7 doors, 8 doors, 9 doors, 10 doors now. All what I see now is 10 doors. Qasim Bai has 10 keys. The key of that door cannot work with that door, right? Each door has a certain key. That's why you have to know how to put the right key in the right door. Now you will get your rizq. Aywa. Sometimes you can say subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah like millions of times. But sometimes you can make certain zikr. Little of this zikr better than all. When you pray one rak'ah in the Masjid al-Haram, equal to 100,000 rak'ah here, right? Oh, 100,000 rak'ah here. 100,000. But in one rak'ah is equal to all of them. One rak'ah, ruku' or rak'ah, unit of salah. In the Masjid al-Nabawi equal to 1,000 here. The Masjid al-Aqsa 500 here. Allah. Now look to the verses, the superiority of your deeds. Now we're going to have the tools and the keys of what? Getting rizq. To have the rizq in easy way, full of blessings. Number one. The key number one, I can say, التوكلوا على الله. To trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I don't need that fake trust. Trust with certainty. Yaqeen. Yaqeen, not fake trust. Because fake trust, Allah can know that. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انقلب عَلَى وَجْهِ خَسْرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ ذَلِكَ الْقِسْمُ الْمُبِينُ. مهم. Some people, they are worshipping Allah like an edge. You know the edge? Like somebody walking the edge. Something good happened to him, I'm okay. Something bad, and he fell, start crying. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمَانِ وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانَنِ. If the insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him and gave him rizq, said, Allah, mashallah, I'm good. Allah's giving me everything good. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testing him with some poverty, say, why Allah is doing that like that with me? And they start crying like a little kid. Worshipping Allah in edge, you know? This is not a strong iman. What kind of certainty this? What kind of tawakkul this? This is tawakkul. This is tawakkul. That's why we have to understand that. Tawakkul ala Allah. Allah said, sign of iman and faith to trust Allah, to depend on only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you ask, ask Allah. If you seek help from Allah. And trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you trust Allah, Allah will give you rizq like that small bird flying morning time, empty stomach. And it's coming back to its nest with what? Full stomach. Aywa. Did you see any bird, doctor or an engineer? Studying UCLA? No. No. It's just a trust. Full of trust. Depending on Allah alone. And with certainty from your heart. Okay. Number two, al-iman wa taqwa. If you have iman, faith, and piety, and you're pious, your liver of iman very strong. You're a strong mu'min, good mu'min, good believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If the people, if the towns, آمَنُوا, believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, His oneness, iman, the word iman, and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that, Allah will send His barakat, His blessings, His rizq, provision from the heaven and from under their foot. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. He said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will find some kind of exit for him from his knots and from his problems. He said also, وَأَلْ لَوْ اسْتَقَامُوا عَلَى الطَّرِيقَةِ لَأَسْقَيْنَاهُمْ مَاءً غَدَقًا. If they follow the straight path, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send rain, lots with abundance, lots of rain, no accountability, no measure, just غَدَقًا, lot. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. He said also, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْتَبْرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Ask your family to establish the prayer, salah, and be patient with them. We are not asking you, Allah said, for rizq. We are the one who is going to give you rizq. Just worship Allah. Means worship Allah and have piety, have iman, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you rizq in the easy way, somehow. This is His job, not your job. Number three, the key number three, tahkim shar' Allah, Allah al-musta'an. You know tahkim shar' Allah, to follow the rules of the sharia of Islam. How to follow the rules of the sharia? If somebody making zina to stone him to death, or somebody steal to cut his hand? No, I'm not talking about that. I am not a ruler. And there is no Islamic rulers nowadays, they are doing that in reality. Maybe they are doing it in Saudi Arabia, Allahu A'lam, this is in the shoulder of their scholars, not in my shoulder. But tahkim shar' Allah, when I took, because in America here when we came, they said Muslims, they come to America to make the Sharia law here. No, we are not coming to America to make the Sharia law in America. Yes, I'm recording now. It is in YouTube. They are watching me. No, we're not coming here to make the Sharia law. You can make the Sharia law in your house, individually. Yes, I will ask my daughters and my family to pray. I will ask my daughter to wear the hijab. Ask my kids to pray. This is the Sharia law. And Sharia law, to be honest with you, 90% of the law of this country, it's a Sharia law. Especially in the welfare and all of that stuff. It is Islam. All the system of the welfare, this is Islam. Umar ibn al-Khattab make it. Yes. But these people, when they think about the Sharia law, what they said, cutting the hands and lashing backs of people and stoning them. No. Actually, this ahkam rules, it is in Islam. It isn't our Sharia, I cannot deny it. But with very, very, very difficult conditions. You cannot even get one condition of this to make it. In case if that can happen, do it. But who can do it? First of all, we have to have the Islamic ruler. We don't have. Number two, you have to have the witness. For example, let's take one part and make it easy to understand it. Adultery. In Islam said if somebody is not married and he make adultery, you have to lash his back how many times? 100 or 80 times? Huh? 100, what about the one who drink al-khamr? That's right, doctor, yeah. مئة جلدة وليشهد عذابهما طائفة من المؤمنين, that's right. 100 lash, you have to lash his back, not me, the ruler, Islamic ruler, 100 times. What about if he's married and he make adultery? They make a hole and they stone him to death. But with the condition, what the condition? If any one of you can find one condition, stand and let me know. Somebody make adultery, okay? And he been married. Let's take the worst case. He been married and he's married and he make adultery. And they make a hole for him. طيب. The judge is going to ask him, are you married? Yes, I'm married. Did you make adultery? He said, no. طيب. Can you find four witnesses? With condition. They have to be Muslims. Not just a Muslim. Any Muslim. Just Muslim. Udul. You can accept their witness. Yeah, testimony, you can accept it. and the four of them they are mature Muslims, عاقل, they are not insane. Not just that, and they have to declare it to the judge. We saw that man making the other three with our own eyes. نعم. How can you see it with your own eyes? Do you know what I mean? Or on your own eyes? Not just the man above the lady or the lady above them. No, you have to see everything in details. نعم. Nobody can see that. Can you find anybody in the world that can find this? Okay, assume with me, two of them or three, they will say, yeah, we saw. Are you sure the fourth one gonna see this? Never gonna happen. Until you go yourself to the Muslim and to the judge and tell him, because I don't want to say it in the YouTube. One young girl, she talked to me from California, from New York, before like almost 1 month. And she told me, Sheikh, I make adultery. I'm a single, but I make other. She just convert last year. I never saw her. Somebody give her my phone number. And she said, what I have to do? I need somebody to lash my back 400 times. I was laughing. I said, you need somebody in America to lash your back 400 times? Who said that? She said, this is what the Quran said. I said, sister, don't do that. She said, but already I found somebody. I said, where? She said, in the college. And she said, they are not Muslims. I said, what? I was laughing again. And I said, sister, don't do that. I start explaining to her, make tawbah, and then do it again. She's just a new Muslim. Somebody Muslim deceived her. Deceived her, and I give her some advice. That's it. Make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's all. You know, ask Allah for repentance. That's all. Now, sometimes you see some stuff so difficult. You have to understand al-hudud. That rules in Islam, it is not easy. Not me or you, the one who can judge this and he can make this stuff. But at least when you say tahkim shara Allah in your house, in very nice way, and act like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam with mercy, kindness, gentleness, and be a good Muslim. That's all. Mercy is good. This one thing. Look what the ayah said. Allah talk about the Christian Jews, the people of scripture. ولو أنهم أقاموا التوراة والإنجيل لأكلوا من فوقهم ومن تحت أرجلهم. If they follow the Torah and the Injil, the scriptures, Allah will feed them from the above their heads and under their feet. سبحان الله. Or under their foot. Also this ayah for us, if we follow the Quran, right? Not just for the people of the scripture, we have to follow the Quran too. If you follow the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feed you from all the ways. He will give you food. Number four, at-tawbah wal-istighfar. The key, number four, to ask Allah for repentance, to repent to Allah, and to ask for forgiveness. You don't have to make sin to be a sinner to ask Allah for forgiveness or tawbah. Just make it. In case, if you make sin, increase saying, oh, Allah, forgive me, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. And you know the story of Sayyidina Nuh, when Hassan al-Basri, Abu Sa'id, he was sitting teaching his students in the masjid. A man came and said, yeah, Abu Sa'id, we don't have rain. You know, what I have to do? He said, Abu Sa'id, Hassan al-Basri said, go ask Allah for his forgiveness. After a while, another man came. He said, yeah, Abu Sa'id, to Hassan al-Basri, I have no kids. I'm looking for kids. Ask Allah for me. He said, man, go ask Allah for forgiveness. Say, astaghfirullah. Yeah, third man came and said, I am poor. I need money. He said, go ask Allah for his forgiveness. And everybody's coming, ask for forgiveness. What is this? And the students of Hassan al-Basri, they said, yeah, Imam, you get different three or four questions and you answered with the same answer. Ask Allah for forgiveness. And they said, didn't you read what Allah said in the Quran? فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. Didn't you read what Allah said? Ask Allah for His forgiveness. He will give you money, wealth. He will give you children. He give you jannat, gardens. He give you whatever you want. This is what He said. Also, brothers, وَأَنِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ مَتَّعْكُمْ مَتَاعًا حَسَنًا إِلَى أَجَلٍ مُسَمًّى ويؤتي كل ذي فضل فضل. سيدنا هود, Prophet Hood, he told his people, ask Allah for forgiveness, he will give you متاع, good life, متاع حسنة, good life, happy life, متاع حسنة, ويؤتي كل ذي فضل فضله. He will give you a lot without any accountability. Ask forgiveness يا جماعة. The best thing in your life to ask for forgiveness. أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. If you are in problem, poverty, no job, no business, no happiness, you're not healthy. Say أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. إمام أحمد بن حنبل أياس مش أحمد بن حنبل إمام ابن تيمية. ابن تيمية said I used to sit and think about المسألة in the fiqh of Islam, Islamic jurisprudence. And sometimes I did not get the solution. And what I used to do, he said, at night I used to sit like this, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi, 1,000 times. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me and gave me the answer of what, of that mas'ala of fiqh or Islam. See, forgiveness, ya jama'ah, if you ask Allah for forgiveness, that's a big and a strong weapon in your hand. A dua and asking Allah forgiveness. طيب. One of these keys also, to get the provision or livelihood, Allah, again, Allah, without these keys, you will get it. But in difficult way, you will work hard to get this. Maybe you will get it without blessings. To work hard, to get it, and you're gonna waste it, gonna vanish from your hand, empty hand again. But when you get it in easy way, and Allah will bless it, gonna remain with you. You get the benefit of this wealth, and that money, and that rizq. Subhanallah. Why I'm talking about the blessings? Somebody has 10 kids, and these 10 kids he was working all of his life to raise them in very good way. But somehow Allah did not bless him with his kids. And somebody has just 2 kids or 3 kids, but he's a good Muslim. He used to make dua, he used to ask Allah for dua for his kids and all of that. Allah blessed him with these 2 or 3 kids better than these 10 kids. Why? Because that one who has 10 kids, maybe in the end of his life, they're going to throw him in the nursing home or whatever. You know, they're going to throw him in the street. I'm just giving you an example. Dua, ya jama'a, dua, one of the keys of livelihood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. Dua. Very fast, I don't want to go with more details because of time. Allah said, وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَأَتَاكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ. In the last third of every night, Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering us with 3 things. Last coming to our heaven, how without how, don't ask about this. This is beyond our knowledge. Without how, بِلَا كَيْف, is coming to our heaven. يَتَنَزَّلْ رَبُّنَا, he descend to our heaven. And he's asking, offering. Who's offering you? Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need anything from us? No. We are in need to him. He doesn't need us. He's self-sufficient, independent. Samad. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah offering you with 3 things. Anybody asking for repentance, I will accept his repentance. Allah is offering you, and when sleeping, Allah is asking anyone asking for forgiveness, I will forgive him. We are heedless about that. Anyone asking for anything, do you need anything? Ask me. And you are, from like 2 or 3 o'clock, stand, make wudu. Pray to rak'ah, ask Allah from khayri dunya wal akhirah, from the best of this life and the best of the hereafter. Wallahi, he will give it to you. Wallahi, with yaqeen, certainty and tawakkul. This is what I'm saying. Also, brothers, the key number 6 to get your provision, ash-shukr, to be grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in Surah Ibrahim, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. More you will be thankful, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more Allah will give you extras. But if you deny his ni'mah, his bounty, if you deny it and reject it, his punishment severe. This is what he said in the Quran. The key number 7 الإنفاق. When you spend for the sake of Allah. يا شيخ, we're talking about رزق. We need to take, not to give. And now you're telling us to take from Allah to more رزق. You have to spend. Yes. Yes, this is your bet. Huh? When you go with your sonaras to fish for fishing, you have to put your bait, right? And you throw it, right? To get big fish like this. Put something, huh? Put something for the sake of Allah, then that little will bring big fish like this, maybe a shark. See? Yeah, yes, put something, Allah will give you more. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ أَنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ One grain. أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلَ That, سبحان الله, from that one seed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you 7 years. في كل سنبه مات حبا each 100 سبحان والله يضاعف لمن شاء الله واسع عليه الله will give you more the meaning ف spend for the sake of Allah when we talk about the spend for the sake of Allah I have 2 keys in 1 box either you spend for somebody devoting his time for teaching people Islam or learning Islam طالب العلم and this is part of your zakah you can give him or you yourself seek knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make for these 2 people, the one who spend, for the one who's devoting his time and his waqt and his effort for seeking knowledge, and the one who's seeking knowledge himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for him to get his rizq. His rizq will provision, will get it in an easy way like that. My hadith, two brothers during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to share with each other the business. And one of them, he used to sit more with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to learn about Islam and to seek knowledge. And the one who used to work more, he used to complain his brother to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah is leaving me alone in my business and he's sitting all the time in the masjid seeking knowledge, Ya Rasulullah, coming to you, Ya Rasulullah. Ask him to help me, Ya Rasulullah. And Rasulullah said, لَعَلَّكَ تُرْزَقْ بِهِ He said, maybe or might be, Allah Almighty is giving you rizq, make it easy for you because of him. Because of him. Because he's seeking knowledge. See? فالله سبحانه وتعالى, the one who can make it easy for you, the ways for you to get rizq in an easy way. Also, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, To Bilal, أنفق بلال ولا تخشى من ذي العرش إقلالا. And Bilal ibn Rabah was a slave, very poor person. And Rasulullah said, Ya Bilal, don't be stingy. Give for the sake of Allah. Allah, the one who owns the arsh, the throne. Do you think he will not give you rizq? Give, Ya Bilal. And Bilal was very poor. What about if Rasulullah come to our time now and they see these banks now and these billions of dollars and trillions of dollars? With people and they are very stingy. And Bilal, slave, miskeen, muazzin of Rasulullah. Bilal, spend. Allah, the one he owned the arsh, he will give you, don't worry. And said, ما نقصت صدقة من مال. صدقة will never decrease your money, will increase it. Yes, you have to take it with certainty again, yaqeen. And when you spend, brothers, also, Try to spend, this is one of the keys also. Try to spend more to the fuqara and the masakeen, those who are in need, the poor people. Those who are in need to your help. Look for them. Because Rasulullah said in the hadith, لَعَلَّكَ said إِنَّمَا تُرْزَقُونَ وَتُجْبَرُونَ وَتُنْصَرُونَ بِضُعَفَائِكُمْ Because of this type of weak people in your community, like the orphaned, the miskeen, the poor, those who are in need, they are weak in the community. Because of them, Allah sustain you. Allah give you, provide rizq for you. Allah make you victorious, give you victory because of these people. More you have mercy to these weak people, the widows, miskeen, somebody sick, somebody poor, in need. These people, look at them. More you look at them and you help them, Allah will help you and He will give you more, inshallah. The key number 9, Silat al-Rahim, taking care of your kinship. Your kinship, why? Yes, Silat al-Rahim. طبعا حديث من أحب أن يبسط له في رزقه وينسأ له في أثره فليصل رحمه. If you would like Allah سبحانه وتعالى to give you يبسط يعني is opening his hand like this to you. البسط, this is بسط, this is القبض. Huh? Imagine my hand is مقبوضة like this. I'm very stingy. Huh? Tight. My hand is very tight. The opposite, البسط, when Allah open his hand like that. If you want Allah to open his hand like this to give it to you, just take care of your kinship. And taking care of your kinship, there are levels. Some of them, they need just, hello, how are you? You're good? Alhamdulillah, jazakallah. Some of them, they need more help. Yeah, and you can visit. Some of them, they are very poor. If you have money, go help them. There are levels. You can evaluate them. You know your relatives. Yeah. So this is Islam. And if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you more life, healthy, take care of your kinship. And if you die, they will make dua for you. يُنسَأْ لَهُ فِي أَثَرِهِ. They will mention your name with what? With something good. Also number 10, the key number 10, two keys actually. المتابعة between الحج and العمرة. To make عمرة and حج. عمرة and حج. عمرة and حج. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المتابعة بين الحج والعمرة ينفيان الفقر أو الفقرة والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد. To make حج and عمره, عمره to عمره, عمره to go to Saudi Arabia, to make عمره there, to visit the Masjid al-Haram and the Masjid al-Nabawi, to make عمره there, or حج, that will wipe out your poverty like what? Like if you take something rusted, a piece of iron rusted, to the blacksmith and put it in the fire to purify it. Allah will purify your sin and your poverty because of your عمره and حج. If you want to be rich, go make حج and عمره. Also, الهجرة, the key number 11 for inshallah seeking more provision with blessings, livelihood, rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, migrate, may الهجرة في سبيل الله, in the cause of Allah. What الهجرة? If I ask any one of you, why you migrated to America here? Because I love the green, you know the green? Dollar, yes. Sometimes I'm looking in the community, not here in Texas, Louisiana, because they care about money more than people here in California. Alhamdulillah, people in California, Allah give them rizq more. These people, you look at their eyes, you see dollar sign. they love dollar so much. Subhanallah, they get it from haram, halal, they doesn't care. May Allah get them. Yeah, maybe they will listen to this lecture, I'm gonna put it for them. Because I remember that when I was at that masjid in Louisiana, when I talk about Khamr, 90% of the community, they used to sell Khamr there. May Allah guide them. Ameen. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Ameen. They will listen to me, inshallah. They will watch it. When I make khutbat al-jum'ah, when I talk about Khamr is haram, I'm a troublemaker man all of my life. I see them in the khutbah, I make like, they turn their faces from me. And when I face somebody with them, they say, Sheikh Jum'ah. Do you have any way, other way you can work? I said, I came here to give you other way to work. America is the land of opportunities. You can find too many ways to get your money from halal ways. The land of opportunities here in America. You know that better than me. You came to this country before me, and you know that. This is not the way, an excuse to say I came from my country because I have nothing to do, I have no degree. To stand in the liquor store or to sell khamr, it's mal'oon. 10 types of people, they get la'nat. La'nah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are dealing with this. I'm going to repeat this time. I used to write this hadith. I used to put it beside the door for them. When they used to go and go, they say, oh, Sheikh Shum'a. We don't like that man. I don't care. Allahumma hal balaght. This is my job to deliver the message. I'm not forcing you, it's up to you. And if you think it's halal for you, it's halal for you. Like that sister in Texas was telling me, Sheikh Jum'a, she was Egyptian. She was telling me, Sheikh Jum'a, hijab is not fard for women. I said, wallahi, I was debating with her like for 3 hours. Give ayat for Surah Al-Nur, Surah Al-Ahzab, Dalil from the Sunnah, the Quran, the Hadith. She said, no, there is no Dalil. I said, sister, this is what you think? Hijab is not fard, obligatory for you. It's halal for you if you think like that. Why are you mad at me? Halal for you. Do you think I'm the one who's gonna count you on the day of judgment? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hang you from your hair, inshallah. But that's it. what I can say. I get tired of her. 3 hours talking. These people, you cannot change their mind. I'm delivering the message. بس الخمر حرام. Also الهجرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعَةً. If you make hijrah, migrate for the sake of Allah, you will find, mashallah, the land of Allah is big and wide. You can, if you've been oppressed in certain place, you can migrate to a different place. You can live your life with dignity, freedom, and you can educate yourself and your family. Alhamdulillah. And we've been blessed, to be honest with you, because we live in the United States of America. If somebody, any sheikh is telling you no, tell him go to your country while you're here. Yes, I'm gonna say it openly. Because alhamdulillah, we've been secured. We take our kids to the schools. Alhamdulillah, وَآتَاكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوا. You have everything. If somebody wants to tell me no, tell him go to your country while you're here. يَلَّا مَعَ السَّلَامَةِ. We have more than 33 million Muslims in America. Yes, this is what I know. And alhamdulillah, we have our masajid. Alhamdulillah, full of security. We are coming to the masjid to pray with full of peace, peace of mind, peace of heart. And when I see this, that ni'am, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showering us with in this beautiful country, I make dua for our countries. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help these people there. Ameen. This is what I can say. Wallahi, may Allah help them. They are in very bad shape now, especially the Middle East area. Wallahi, very bad shape. Very bad shape. I'm not talking about the money. Or security, may Allah help. Their akhlaq and their manners. Yes, see, maybe you think about poverty. No, Allah Razzaq, the one who gave us rizq here, he gave them rizq there too. And some of them, they have money more than us even here. But the point here is, the problem is their akhlaq, their manners now. Yes, people, they are traveling, they're coming and talk to me. Because I'm the imam, everybody's talking to me and they're giving me calls. And they know that. Salah comes, the time of Salah, nobody's going to the masjid anymore. You see, the girl is there, they are naked in the streets. They are drinking khamr, dancing. They are doing too much stuff. Wallahi al-Azim, some Muslims, alhamdulillah, not some, most of the Muslims in this country, they are sticking with their deen better than these people. And they are praying, they come to the masjid, they have iman better than them. I'm telling you, may Allah help. Also, ذكر الله, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا. Those who are away from the remembrance of Allah, their life is miserable life. They are in misery. Miserable life means that there is no rizq, there is no happiness. Their life upside down. فَمَكَ ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى as much as you can, especially before Maghrib and after Fajr. I will go very fast because of the time. Also, الزواج والنسل. Marry, there's something good. There's something bothering me in this. In some of the communities and some youth, they've been talking to me. They say, Sheikh, why I have to marry? I have my girlfriend. I have in the weekend, we are going doing everything. Why I have to marry? This big burden in my shoulder. This is not right. This is not right. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Al-Mujahid fi sabilillah, the one is making jihad. And again, the word jihad is different from the word qital in the Quran. Qital means fighting. Jihad means struggling and striving. The one is struggling and striving in the cause of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said he will make his rizq easy. We'll give him rizq easily in a very easy way. Number two, al-mukatab. Al-mukatab, during the slavery time, if somebody's slave, he can make deal with his master to work for a certain time to free himself. Allah will help that person too. Number three, which is now, the one who's looking for marriage, the reason is to guard his chastity and his private parts from zina. Allah will help that person too, see? So that's why put in your mind, especially the youth brothers, when you have the ability and you're capable to marry, go marry, don't delay it. Because if, when you, since you married, you get married, you complete half of your deen. Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, when their wives died in the same day, they've been looking for another wife in the same day. Why? He said, maybe I will die today and I will meet Allah while I'm a single person. See? For that's why marriage, ya jama'ah, marriage is to build up Muslim, inshallah. If you somebody give you money as a loan and you take it with the intention to return it back to him, Allah will help you too. Do you know why? Because some people, they take money from you and see you inshallah later. That's why if you give somebody money, ask him to kiss your hand. Before you give him the money, ask him to kiss your hand like this. Do you know why? Because when you're gonna ask him for his money, you're gonna kiss his foot. Yes. I don't want to block it in front of your eyes. No, I just ask you now to spend for the sake of Allah. But really be careful. If you take money from somebody, take it with the intention to return it back to him. Aywa. Niyya. To return it back to him. Not to take the money of the people just without any right. This is Islam. Allah will help you if you take the money from somebody with this niyya. Also, one of these keys, number 14. MashaAllah, I give you 14 keys of rizq now. Just stuck with two or three. It's enough. Yeah. التبكير إلى طلب الرزق. To go early for seeking rizq. Wake up in the morning, come for Salat al-Fajr, and Allah will give you rizq. Look what Rasulullah is making dua for you. What Rasulullah said, اللهم بارك لأمتي في بكورها. Oh Allah, give barakah and bless my ummah when they wake up in the morning praying and they go seeking rizq in the morning. Let's learn from American people. Muslims, let's learn from them. While this in our Islam. Subhanallah. These people, you see them, when you come to Salat al-Fajr, you see that old lady, like 70 years old, with the hair dug. MashaAllah, exercising. Tayyib, wake up in the morning early, make exercise. Come to the masjid for Salat al-Fajr. Go your work early. You see the cars in traffic in the morning, like 4 o'clock. Everybody going to his work. This is Islam. Now I wish if somebody gonna listen to this from our countries, they are making in our countries day, night, and the night day. For example, like New York. If you go to New York, nobody's sleeping. If you go to Cairo also, nobody's sleeping at night. Sahab Ahmed? Yeah. Hey, nobody's sleeping at night. People, they switch it. They are sleeping during the day, they are during the night, the restaurants and everybody, what is this? And Allah said, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. The sunnah of Allah, they switch it. The way of Allah, sleep at night, work during the day. They make it opposite. And they lose both. This is again is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالتبكير يا جماعة. رسول الله said in the hadith, لو تعلم أمتي ما في العتمة والصبح لأتوهما ولو حبوا. If my ummah followers knows the khayrat, the reward of Allah, the blessings of Allah during the subh al-atama, salat al-fajr, they will come to it even if they are crawling. Imagine somebody has no legs. He will be like a baby. He will walk in his legs like crawling like a baby to come for salat al-fajr. If they knew the ajr of it, the reward of it, the blessings of salat al-fajr. That's why come early to it. One of the Arabian poet, what he said, ناموا ولا تستيقظوا ما فاز إلا النوام. He said that. ودعوا التفهم جانبا فالخير ألا تفهموا. طيب يا أخوي هم سمعوا بنصيحتك يا خيب. أي والله إبليس. He's إبليس. Look that not Egyptian. Arabian poems. Poet. I did not know his name. He said, ناموا ولا تستيقظوا. Sleep. Don't wake up. Sleep. And those who are sleeping, the winners. He said that. وَدَعُوا التَّفَهُمَ جَانِبًا. Don't understand. Block your block this. Don't understand. فَالْخَيْرُ. It's better if you're not understanding. He's Iblis. What kind of advice this? Now we have to make the opposite. Sleep early. And wake up for Salat al-Fajr early. And try to understand. The best thing if you understand. Opposite of what he's saying. Also, brothers, one of the keys of provision, itqan al-amal, to perfect your work. If you make something, make it in perfect manner. This is what Rasulullah said, إن الله يحب إذا عمل أحدكم عمل أن يتقنه. Allah loves that from us. If you do something, do it in perfect manner, perfect way. Nowadays, you will like, سبع صنايع والبخت ضايع. يعني إيه سبع صنايع والبخت ضايع؟ I am understanding in everything. If you see somebody said that, I understand everything. I make everything. Tell him you don't understand nothing. I believe about what? التخصص. التخصص اللي هو ايه؟ Speciality. Speciality. I believe in that. If you are a doctor, eye doctor, be eye doctor. Liver doctor, be liver doctor. Don't be everything. If you are a carpenter, be just a carpenter. If you are a sheikh, be just a sheikh. أيوة. أعطي القوس باريها. الشاعر قال كده. أعطي القوس باريها. I cannot go to the poacher and ask him to make operation for somebody sick. Can you do that? To open his stomach and for the poacher. Butcher for meat, you know. Yeah, meat. Person. If you go to the carpenter and you give him dress clothes to fix it for you, doesn't work. Doesn't work. If you ask in a doctor, medical doctor, tabib, we call him tabib. Not even doctor. Doctor, the one who has PhD. Tabib is tabib, يعني medical doctor. يعني. If that tabib, you tell him, I'm not belittling him, but he's tabib. In Arabic, we call him tabib, not doctor. That tabib, I cannot go to him and ask him for fatwa in Islam. He knew nothing about it. Ask him about his specialists, what is his study. That's it. I believe in that, تخصص. I believe in that 100%. بس احنا للأسف شديد, some people, they understand everything. Can you fly? Yes, I can fly. Can you, I give you airplane, can you, yeah, mashallah. Everything he's doing. الصلاة. الصلاة one of the best important keys for the رزق. الصلاة يا جماعة. الله said, وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك. طيب. Now I will mention in these 2 minutes some mistakes how people they think about الرزق. This is the way they think and this is the mistakes they are doing which is not right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he blamed those who used to kill their kids before because of the poverty. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَدَكُمْ خَشَّةَ إِمْلَاقٍ. Don't kill your kids out of the fear of the poverty. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُمْ وَإِيَّهُمْ. We are the one who give you risk, provide you risk and them too. And another ayah said, ولا تقتلوا أولادكم. Don't kill your kids because of the poverty. نحن نرزقهم وإياكم. We give them risk and you bless. يعني don't kill your kids. سبحان الله. I see, I read that report about the Hindu people. Because you know, they are the ones taking care of the dowry of their girls when they grow up. They're making portion for the girls. If they know that the baby girl, they make portion, they kill them. This is exactly same like Arab people before Islam. Same like the Chinese people before. Indian people before, they used to burn the lady alive with her husband. If you know. Before they used to do that. Arab people too. Islam came to honor the women. To honor the women. التنازل عن بعض المبادئ. If somebody humiliate himself because out of the fear of his risk. Don't humiliate yourself. Don't beat yourself down, brother. The one who gives you risk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, رزقكم وفي السماء رزقكم وما توعدون. Some people, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them with some poverty also, they give up and they sit with lots of grief and sadness and all of that. فالله subhanahu wa ta'ala said, صبر جميل فعدم استبطاء الرزق. Just make dua, Allah will give it to you, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كل يوم هو في شأن. يعني يفخر ويغني وكذا. There are too many explanations. What you have to do, dua. Dua, as much as you can. Ya Rabbi, Allah give me, Allah help me. That's very important, inshallah. Some people also, they are hastening their rizq and they're getting their rizq from haram ways, unlawful sources, and ways. This is not right also. This is not right at all. So that's why you have to understand that. اتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب لن تموت نفس حتى تستوفي أجلها ورزقها. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get your money, get your wealth, get your food from halal source, halal way, and you will not die until Allah will fulfill your rizq, inshallah. خذوا ما حل ودعوا ما حرم. If whatever Allah make it halal, take it, and whatever Allah make it haram, just be away from that.